Hi, SouthPoint friends and family. You and I are currently dealing with a situation that our generation has never faced before. And if we're honest, it can feel a little scary. And that's normal and fair. Now, when we look back at this season in our lives, there's a word that many of us will use to define it. And I believe that word is uncertainty. However, if we're honest, there's another word that describes something all of us are desperately seeking in this unique season. And that word is peace. Wouldn't we all like a little bit of peace? My hope for our time together over the next several days is that I could share how you, how me, and how we could find the peace that we long for in this uncertain time in history. Today, I just want to share a simple discovery that I had about peace and what it means to experience it. For me, I unknowingly had the wrong definition of peace for most of my life. You see, I thought peace meant that there was an absence of discomfort, that there was an absence of inconvenience, and there was an absence of uncertainty. And for me, and for maybe for you, here's how I defined peace. It went something like this. I'll have peace when the world works the way I want it to. And if you're anything like me, we've probably been disappointed on a regular basis. Somehow, in a moment of clarity, I grasped the insanity of my definition of peace. And maybe today you will too. And here's what I mean. We live in a broken world. We live in a world where everyone's flawed, myself included. Yet I keep expecting the results from a fantasy world that really doesn't exist, and that I want life to go the way I want it to. No wonder my disappointment level is high and I stay anxious. I keep asking the world to deliver something it can never give me. Now you may already know this, but peace is impossible if our expectations are that life will go the way we exactly want it to. Our unrealistic expectation and the reality of a broken world with flawed people will always be in conflict with each other. And that's because the very definition of peace is that there's an absence of conflict or struggle. Now, when it comes to experiencing peace, many of us believe that this peace that we seek is some guru state of being where we become emotionless beings who are never fazed by the brokenness of this world. And by the way, that's not peace. That's an unhealthy disassociation with reality. Peace isn't the absence of discomfort. Peace is not the absence of inconvenience. Peace is not the absence of uncertainty. Peace is where there's no conflict. The very word peace means to describe that there's no fight or disagreement. Now, in a broken world with flawed people, you and I can't avoid struggle. And it leaves us asking, is peace impossible? And I've discovered that I often lack peace personally because I forget the true definition of peace. You see, peace really means that there's no fight, there's no quarrel, there's no argument about the goodness of my future or our future or our future. Peace happens when we let go of trying to control every situation and we hold on to the truth that circumstances are temporary, but the victory of the cross is eternal. The cross of Christ has conquered the worst chaos that life could throw at you or me. The empty tomb means Jesus has defined our destiny and it is good regardless. No matter how this scene of life goes, the ending is already filmed and Jesus wins and so we win. So here's my challenge to you and I today. What's our definition of peace? Because if we have the wrong definition, we'll never experience the peace we long for. And that would be a bigger tragedy even than the uncertainty that we face today. Maybe we just need to let go and trust that God's goodness and grace will deliver a destiny that is unshakable in Jesus. As I close, I want you to remember throughout the day that we're facing something that's totally new to your children and their life is turned upside down. You should probably expect some chaos. Remember that your spouse may be worrying about unemployment or performing their job remotely. We should expect different. Remember that our neighbors, they may not have the hope in Christ that you do. We should expect self-preservation. Maybe if you and I stop expecting a broken world to deliver fantasy results, we may actually experience the peace we so badly need. I want to leave you with the words of Jesus today. He says, "My peace I leave with you. My peace I give you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled and do not be afraid. And don't forget in this season, you matter deeply to God."